slimed me.
That's great! Actual physical contact!
Kevin, it's great to have you here today. Thank you so much. As a Ghostbuster, I want to thank you for bringing Ghostbusters to McDonald's at the movies.
And as a Ghostbuster, you're welcome. as you, the Ghostbuster. I'm not a Ghostbuster.
Well, and that's what actually was going to be one of my questions, is do you consider yourself a ghost head and a Ghostbusters fan?
I'm a fan for sure, but I haven't done enough of the work. I don't have anything like to wear like that. I think it would be cheating to say I'm a ghost head.
Yeah, that's okay.
Like, no, that like a dead head?
Yeah, exactly. So
no, only because I'm lazy. But I'm a fan of the movie. Yes.
Well, not all of us, you know, dress up like this. But again, as fans, we'd like to know what it is that made you choose this movie for tonight for us.
It has special memories for me. The summer of it was the summer where I was starting with the kids in the house we know now, working stage trip. So comedy was in my life a lot, and I was a movie usher, so I ushered Ghostbusters.
Oh, cool.
I actually mostly have seen the movie out of order, because you go into theater at different times. I've seen it in order a few times, that was so long ago, I just remember it out of order. And it was sort of a special summer, and Bill Murray, I was a big fan of Bill Murray when I was a kid, like almost 10 years before that.
Yeah.
And as I'll say before the movie, it's just rare that it's one of those like big special effects comedies that actually is funny.
Mm-hmm.
That they also cared about the comedy of it. And I enjoyed that very much. And so I have only fond memories for it.
Well, and again, that sort of brings me to another question. You mentioned sort of the timing of it in terms of the formation of the Kids in the Hall troupe. Where do you think it fits in terms of the connection to Canadian humor? As somebody that's part of one of the cornerstones, I mean, we think about Bill Murray. Exactly, and that's why I was curious what your thoughts were on Aykroyd, Harold Ramis. You know.
Ivan Reitman,
exactly.
Harold Ramis, Dan Aykroyd, and they wanted John Candy to be Louis Tully.
Yeah.
You know that, you're a Ghostbuster.
Yeah. and they got another Canadian, Rick Moranis.
It was, there's a very big Canadian connection. That was sort of the beginning of the Canadian days, like SCTV and Second City started to get the first wave of Canadian comics going, I think. Wayne and Schuster was a tiny wave.
Yeah.
And then there was a bigger wave by the early 80s, I think.
And do you have any favorite characters, favorite moments, things that make you go, wow?
I haven't seen it for so long. Well, Bill Murray is one of my idols of all time, so anything he did. I think anytime he's screening, even the first scene with him when he's doing the shock thing and he shocks the guy but not the woman, that's really hilarious. But the thing I remember nowadays that people see for the first time, I don't think it would get such a big laugh because of Nickelodeon, sliming became a big thing.
Mm-hmm.
But the first time, I always walked in for that part for some reason. The first time Bill Murray gets slimed, he said, what does he say here? The Ghostbuster, they slimed me or I've been slimed?
Yeah, I've been slimed.
That got the biggest laugh I've ever heard in the movies, like ever.
Yeah.
And it was night after night after night. It was like sold out for 6 months.
Yeah.
So, not so much that it was so funny, though it was, because I think he's the first guy that made slime like a verb.
Verb, yeah.
Yeah. Just that he said that and he was covered in slime and he was doing deadpan, it was it just got the laugh of it. The actual laugh more than joke is like a big fond memory.
Yeah, no, it's a fond memory for us too. So
yeah, it's funny, a lot of kids went to the movie, it was a lot of families. Kids loved it and adults loved it.
Yeah.
It was like sort of like Pee Wee Herman later on, a year or two later. It was loved by all ages.
Well, that's cool. Well, thank you so much for bringing it to McDonald's movies. Thank you for being willing to sort of be interviewed by us, the Winnipeg Ghostbusters.
Of course.
And thank you so much.